So hi, hello and welcome again, Microbehunter here. Well, look at this beautiful Asian lady beetle that I have here. It looks a little bit like a ladybug, but actually it's not. It's a different, entirely different species. Today I would like to discuss a little bit the differences between bugs and beetles, because the lady beetle over here is quite different from a true bug. Yeah, and very often these two terms, beetles and bugs, are used interchangeably, but actually from a biological viewpoint there is quite a big difference in here. So just a little bit of background information. I found this lady beetle here a few days ago in my apartment. It's an invasive species. We've got quite a few of those now in our garden, and it does look similar to the lady bugs, but actually the pattern is different. And not only that, these are not even quite as friendly as the lady bugs, because they even are able to bite. Okay, so what I've done now is I placed a microscope slide on top of the beetle so that I'm able to see the bottom part a little bit better, and I was a little bit surprised to see how extremely strong this insect actually is. Yeah, it's able to crawl along, and to my surprise it was even able to hold tight to the smooth glass surface, and it was able to crawl out beneath the microscope slide, and then yeah, it was able to essentially free itself. But when you want to look at the differences between bugs and beetles specifically, then this one over here is actually quite a nice illustration here, because beetles, what they have is they have front wings, and that's basically the red outer part here with the black dots. That is actually the front wing, right? And you can see that this front wing is more or less uniform all over the body. Yeah? So it is a huge, large section. That is one of the important distinguishing criteria to the true bugs, because the bugs actually have wings that are divided. Both bugs and beetles have two pairs of wings, but it's actually the front wing that is different. Yeah, here, now it managed again to crawl out. And here we can see again here that the whole wing, front wing, actually is uniform all the way all the way to the back. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to now show you a true bug which I found also yesterday. Here it is. I think a very beautiful specimen. It's alive, but it's not quite as active as the lady beetle that we've just seen. Over here, this one is a true bug, because the structure of the wings is quite different here. And specifically, I want you to place a strong focus not only on the front wing here, but especially here in the corner. Later on, we're going to see this a little bit better. You can actually see that the wing is divided, right? Because the top, not the top part, but the front part of the wing actually is different than the back part. Here we can see again a little bit the head with the two gigantic compound eyes staring at me. Well, of course, all the beetles have compound eyes, the antenna over here as well. But the wing actually is the part that is actually the important difference here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to move a little bit forward, and that's actually the place that I would like to show you a little bit in more detail. And what we have here is this dark, large area here is actually the hind part of the front wing, and you can see that it looks black, but in reality it's actually transparent. It only looks black now because it's lying directly on top of the body of the insect. But you see over here that there is this dividing line here, right? And this is basically the place where the front part of the wing over here is hardened. It's called sclerotinized, because sclerotin, that is a protein that actually gives the wing quite a bit of a structural strength. And the membranous part down here is non-sclerotinized. And the fact that the wing is divided into these two sections, the front wing, is actually an important criterion for distinguishing bugs from beetles, right? So the next time when you find an insect, and just have a look if you're actually able to see something a little bit like this, like a V shape over here, which is kind of the dividing area between the front part and the back part of the wing. Okay, so that is essentially something that also gives the bugs their name. They're called heteroptera, hetero coming from Greek meaning other, and ptera basically means wings. So they have essentially wings that are not uniform all the way through, but actually are divided into two different sections. And that's basically the thing that I would like wanted to explain to you in this video. And besides that, I have to tell you those insects are actually quite interesting and nice looking. I mean, especially under the microscope, I'm always fascinated by the intricacy and still to a certain extent also the beauty of those animals. These are highly complex living creatures with probably thousands of sensory here, optimized for the survival. Very fascinating. But from me, that's all I wanted to share with you today. I hope that you enjoyed the video. Of course, I would like to invite you to subscribe to this channel. Leave your comments below. Maybe some of you are able to identify this specific specimen over here, this bug. Please leave it. Leave your comments in the comment section below. But for me, that's all. I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting, as always. See you around next time. Bye-bye.